Inshallah, we'll continue our series, understanding the du'as that we recite in the salat. Like we said last week, sometimes we go 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 years reciting some du'as in the salat, and we have no clue what we are saying. And alhamdulillah, last week we explained du'a al-istiftah, subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيرك. And we mentioned also that one of the ways in order to achieve khushu' in the salat is to get the brain involved in the salat. Now mechanically, automatically, the minute I say Allahu Akbar, immediately سبحانك اللهم without any thinking. But we have many options. We have many options of authentic du'a. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم used other than this dua before the Fatiha. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we will take the second authentic one. What does that mean? That means one day or one salat, I say subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik wa tabarak asmuk. And the other salat, I will say this one, inshallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was praying with the sahaba. And then one of the sahaba said, Allahu akbaru kabira. والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. When Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم finished the salat, he turned around. He said, من القائل? Who's the one who uttered these words? So one of the people, one of the companions said, أنا يا رسول الله. Me, myself يا رسول الله. He said, عجبت لها. I'm very surprised of it. فتحت لها أبواب السماء. All doors of Jannah, all doors of heaven were opened for it. Allahu Akbar. So Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhuma, the narrator of the hadith, he said, since that day, I never abandoned saying this dua. So, after Allahu Akbar, before the Fatiha, Allahu Akbar kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukrata wa asila. What does it mean? Of course, all the words are very familiar and they're very easy, but we'll explain them to better improve our understanding. Allahu Akbar kabira, Allahu Akbar. Do you know that Allahu Akbar is the most word every practicing Muslim utters on a daily basis? If somebody asks you, what is the most word that you say on a daily basis? The most word, it is Allahu Akbar. Between the salawat, between repeating after the muadhin, between the iqama, between the adhkar after the salat, between the adhkar before sleeping, if you add them all up, it goes above 400 times a day, specifically Allahu Akbar. So I'm saying Allahu Akbar kabira. Imagine we say 400 times a day or more, Allahu Akbar. But what does it mean? Do I live by Allahu Akbar? Do I live by the most word I recite on a daily basis? Is Allah Akbar in your life? Is Allah Akbar than your job? Is Allah Akbar than your family? Is Allah Akbar than the haram income? Is Allah Akbar than whatever you're doing wrong? Is Allah Akbar than that meeting to get up and pray your salat? Is Allah Akbar than anything that could distract you from Allah Azza wa Jal? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Why it's not Subhanallah when I start the salat? Why it's not Alhamdulillah and I start? Allahu Akbar. Leave everything and go back to Allah Azza wa Jal. And add to it Kabira. When we add the same word, that means we are confirming the greatness of Allah. Allah is not only Akbar, Allahu Akbar Kabira. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Walhamdulillahi Kathira. Subhanallah. We all know Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, not only Alhamdulillah, Kathira, abundantly. I was just reading a quote of Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah. Wallahi, he said, whomsoever think that the blessings are only food and drink and shelter and afiyah. Whomsoever think that the ni'am he has are only food and drink and shelter and health, then he is lacking wisdom. Albatta, he has no wisdom whatsoever. Because the blessing of Islam, the blessing of Iman, the blessing of coming to the Salat, the blessing of guidance, that is way much higher than the blessing of eating and drinking. Animals eat and drink. So alhamdulillah kathira. First kabira, kathira. Yani for my brothers and sisters that non-Arab, very easy. Allahu akbaru kabira, walhamdulillah kathira. Wa subhanallah bukratan wa asila. So this is probably the two new words that might come to your vocab. Bukratan, early in the morning. Usually bukra is between fajr and shuruq. Asila is between Asr and Maghrib. So, yani I am glorifying Allah. I am making tasbih to Allah day and night. Bukratan wa asila. Does that mean in between I'm not doing it? No. When we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbul Mashriqi wal Maghrib. He is the Rabb of Mashriq and Maghrib. That automatically means that He is also the Rabb of what's in between. So similarly, when I say I'm making tasbih bukratan wa asila, that means I'm making tasbih constantly, day and night. So subhanallah, ya akhwan. Very simple dua to say instead, by the way, you do not say two dua of istiftah. One, either this or that, or the ones that we are going to study in the following weeks that are coming. So when I say Allahu Akbar, automatically, usually, Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, which was like we said last week, one of the best dua ever, 100% authentic, okay? But next salat, this sunnah that I'm going to pray right now, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukrata wa asila. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم and then you start. Please, very simple dua. Otherwise, wallahi, all mechanical. Yalla. This, inshallah, series, بإذن الله تعالى, if we follow the steps, you will feel the change in your salat. So let's do it as usual. Repeat after me. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلة. MashaAllah. Fajr tomorrow is at 5:30. I know it's very early, but wallahi, it's worth it. Tomorrow is Jum'ah. The best salat in the sight of Allah is Fajr of Jum'ah in Jama'ah. Brother Wasim, his mother is in the hospital. Please keep her in your dua. May Allah give her full shifa. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين.